Hello, I'm Dr. Preston Smith. I developed the Wet Stop 3 Plus alarm. It's our newest version, or something we're really proud of. I'm here to show you what the contents are and how to use the alarm and how to avoid any problems and to kind of help troubleshoot some of the issues you may have so that you can have the best outcome, of course. The bedwetting alarms are very successful for bedwetting treatment, but of course they need to be used properly. So you can see here that this is the alarm and this is the sensor. And one thing you're gonna notice right off the bat is that the sensor is kind of coiled up. It's been in a box and I think it's nice and durable, and I'd give it a little tug and straighten it out. Now on one end of this sensor, you'll see almost it's like a telephone jack, and that clips into the side of the alarm here, as you can see. This little blue tab is to try to help protect the plastic part of that clip so it doesn't break. This is pretty sturdy, but we of course don't want any kids to give it a good full yank because it is a wired device, and that could actually cause the contacts not to be any good. Now on the back, after you've attached the sensor, you will see that the battery door is easily removed. And there are easy instructions on the inside on how to put the two AAA batteries with the positive and negative poles of the battery. Now inside, and we'll show you a close-up, is a switch in which there is an A, a V, and an AV. A is for alarm, and that's for the sound alarm. V is for vibration, and AV is for alarm and vibration. Most people probably want alarm and vibration because some of these kids can be really hard to wake. So you want as much bang for your battery as possible. So I would recommend that you put it on the VA or the AV, which is for vibrate and alarm. But of course, you get to choose which setting you would like. Then after the batteries are in, you would just simply close the battery door and locks. Now, you'll notice that there's this swivel on the back. And this is where this alarm is going to clip to the pajama top. So in my case, my shirt, you would literally clip it here and you can see it tugs and it holds. So this is where the alarm is going to clip to the top, near the child's ear, if you will. It could be on the left or right side. And then this end, and put it underneath the shirt top and feed all the way down to the underwear to the pull-up. Now this patented sensor is going to be very good because this is what you're going to clip onto the underwear in the area of the target zone where the wetness is, and you're going to clip it down and it'll hold and tug. And I'm going to show you just quickly on my shirt that if you clip this on there, that this will hold. And so that should work. And so that's kind of the initial setup. And let me just kind of remind you a couple things here. First of all, that you want to put in your batteries correctly. You want to make sure that your child is told not to tug and pull on this, that you keep this rubber protector of the plastic tab in place, that you put the sensor in the area of where the wetness occurs, on probably on the outside of the underwear is best, but you could put it on the inside, and it can actually be placed in a pull-up if you prefer. And make sure that your internal switch is to the setting that you want, either alarm, vibrate, or alarm and vibrate. Lastly, we would tell you that once the alarm goes off, that basically there's this side button here that you would push to quiet it, and that will quiet it. However, if this is still attached to wet underwear, it's then going to start re-triggering. So you probably want to silence it and then detach the sensor from the wet underwear or from the pull-up, dry it off, and your alarm will stay quiet. Now there is a new feature to this particular alarm in which you could push and hold this for approximately 3 to 4 seconds while your child is asleep for approximately about an hour, and it'll make the alarm start to alarm or vibrate depending on your setting. That will allow you to kind of pre-awaken and allow your child to start to adjust and learn to waking with the sound of the alarm. So let's say your child goes to bed at 9 o'clock. You went in at 10 o'clock and you activated this alarm by pushing and holding. It will all of a sudden start to alarm. You wake up your child, even though they've not wet yet. You take them to the restroom and it starts to help their subconscious and their mind level rise up enough to where they then start to associating using restroom with the alarm sound. So therefore, when you take them back to bed and they do have an accident, let's say at 2 in the morning, they're more likely to acknowledge that alarm sound, wake up, and use the restroom like they're supposed to. So that's an additional feature of this alarm that's not available in any other alarms, and that's why it's the WetStop 3 Plus. And again, thank you for watching this short video on how to use the WetStop 3 Plus. We, of course, are very proud of this alarm. But if you have any problems, any questions, just want to let us know how your progress or have issues, concerns, contact us, please, at wetstop.com. And we'll be happy to respond as quickly as possible. Thank you, and hope you have dry nights.
Please give us a thumbs up, comment, and be sure to subscribe.